Boys and girls, welcome back to Mimi's Fun Time. Today, we are going to be making a wire maze. Well, why not? And if you don't know what a wire maze is, it has beads on it and the wire goes around here and here and here and here and here and here and over there. Wow! Fun. But anyway, here's what one looks like. I'm gonna put this piece of paper up here so you can see it because you won't be able to if I just hold it up. But here is what we are going to make. A wire maze. A beaded wire maze, if you want to put it that way. Yeah. Isn't that just fun? So, I'm going to bring you right on down, and we're going to get started. See you in just a few. Okay, for your supplies that you need for this wire maze, will be one of these plaques that you can get from the craft store or any little hobby place. And I already have one and I painted it already. And you need something to put on your base to make your wires go up around. And I'm using corks. And I took one of them and cut it in two. And you will need a nail to make a hole for your wire to go into your cork. I just have one of these right here that I use for my other machine, but you can use a nail very easy. And go ahead and make one in this one. For this one. Alright, and you know, need some wire cutters, some beads. I have different kinds. You can use pony beads if you want. Just anything to put on your wire. I'm using these. No, anything fun. And of course, you need your wire. And your paint. If you want to paint your beads, you can. And I will probably touch some paint up on some of the wood ones just to give it a little bit more color. And, oh, and a hot glue gun. Remember, adults only. Kiddos, let your parents help you. Okay. So now that I already have this board painted, my base, you want to call it. I am going to take my corks and place them. Let's see, you put them anywhere you want. I think I might have these go this way. Yeah, why not? Take your hot glue gun. Put some a generous amount of glue on it and squish it down. You want to make sure it's nice and secure. Smash it down as far as you can. It does not matter if the glue comes out around the edges. Just press. There we go. Same with this other one. And press. Smash it down. All right. Now, before we put these down, the little ones, I want to figure out exactly how high do I want this to come up? You can make it go any way you want, all crazy. It's all about having fun. All right, so here's my wire. Use copper wire, or you can use a coat hanger, anything for your beads to go into. And I don't know what I'm doing there. I need to take this off of there. Silly Mimi. Okay. Take your copper wire, and the straighter you get it, or get all these little lumps and bumps out of it, makes it go easier for your little thing. You can leave all these little loop-de-loops, which is gonna make it fun, which I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna leave the little loop-de-loops. Fun, fun, fun. Okay. Let's see. I can make that one go really high if I want. So, I'm gonna bring this loop down a little bit more, make it a little bit smaller. Make sure you don't put no kinks in it, because you want your beads to go around and around. Fun, fun, fun. Okay, let's straighten this up. Make sure. Just want to test it out first to see how high I want it to go. And I think that would be high enough, so I can snip it here. And straighten it out and see if I need to snip it a little bit more. Which I probably will. We will see. Yeah, let's do it a little bit more, maybe. Let me see. Okay. I'm gonna snip just a little bit more off of there. Just testing it. Because when we get ready to get it together, we're gonna put some glue on there. And you really don't need any glue to put it down in there, but this just keeps it secure, just to make sure that it doesn't, the kids don't pull it off. Yep, you kiddos. Sometimes y'all can get a little roughy toughy. Okay, just like this. Now, next, we want to see where we want to put these, right here, which we can make them come maybe this way, or a little at an angle this way. Let's see. I think I would do it right here. Yep. Okay. Glue it down. Squeezy, squeezy, squeezy. Remember, put plenty of glue. And squeeze it down. Just take your hand, or the back of your palm right there, and squish it down. Don't matter. If you get glue, that's fine. Because you can always paint over it, or you can just wipe it off. Either one. Which I think I'll just take a little bit of it off, because I kind of smushed it at an angle and it went sliding like a sleigh. Okay. And let's put this one in the same spot. Right there. Squish, squish. Oops. Okay. Squish it down. Remember, we don't want to glue this in yet. We're just trying to see where we want to put the wire. And then we're going to take it apart again, except for the base of it. And put our beads on it. Okay. Take your wire again. Straighten the edge. It's very easy to do. And the wire that I'm using comes from Walmart. Let me see if I can find the gauge on it. It's 16 gauge wire, which is all you need. Okay. Now we want this one to go down here, so we don't want to make it too long. It was down right there. And we can make this one go loop-de-loop-de-loop-de-loop side to side if we want. And I might just do another little loop-loop. We'll figure it out when we get a wire. I got a few little kinks. Oh, we can get them out. Just kind of put a little pressure on it and it will smooth right on out. Okay, how do I want to go with this one? Well, we already know we don't need much wire. I can put another little loop. What do y'all think? Should I put another loop or should I make it go side like a snake? Wing, 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 wing. Or all right. Let's see. Let's figure this one out. How do we want to do it? Oh, that would be fine. Why don't we just put a loop in the middle of it? Yeah. All right. We can do a loop. Oops, I don't think I made my little hole in there. Yeah. Let's test it out. Let's see. Push it down in there. Okay. Did I put my hole in this one? Let me see. I don't think I did. So we will have to make one. Alright, let's see. I'm gonna bring out one more loop. Maybe we can get it out of there. There we go. Oh, how about that? That looks fun. Huh? That'd be nice to be a little bitty old stinker bug. And get on a bead and ride it like a roller coaster. Snip that off. See, I'm going to leave this one. You can take your loop. That's why it's so easy with this wire that is rolled up. Because all you had to do is do a little bit of stretching and you can turn it up. See? Make it go in any direction you want. Very easy project. I'm going to push it down in there. Oh, look at that. Isn't that fun? All right. Make sure I push it all the way down to the bottom. There we go. And so you really don't need no glue in there whatsoever. But if you feel like you need to, you can. But don't look like I really need. All right. So now that we have it all fixed, see there? There we go. Isn't that just neat? Now it's time to put our beads on. Alright. Let's see. I'm going to pull that apart a little bit. Make sure our beads go around and around. Pull that down. There we go. Alright. Now I'm going to take my beads and start putting them on. So you just pull one end out. Let's do the bottom ones first. Pull the end out. And you can paint these, remember, if you want. Just put a color bead on it. That one's fun. Maybe. Okay. About that one. That one's got something in it. I think that I will just stay with the wooden ones. How about that? Make them go around easier. See? Easy, 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 easy peasy. Yeah. We'll just do that. I'll just use these wooden beads here, which you can get at any craft store. Oh, wait a minute. I had some different sizes in there. I didn't even know it. All right, well, we're going to redo this one. Yep. Take this apart. I sure did not know that I had different sizes. I need to get some eyeballs to go in here. Okay, got a bigger one and a little smaller one. Gonna put a little bigger one. Gonna get a smaller one. That makes it even better. Dig over here in my little pile of beads. All right. I'm gonna get a bigger one. And a smaller one. Okay. Let's stick this back down in there and we'll give it a whirl. If I can find my hole again, where to go? Oh goodness. There it is. Alright. Let's take it for a whirl, shall we? Okay, we got our beads. Whee! There we go. How about that? Ta-da! That's pretty exciting. Hey! Alright, now let's put some on the bigger one. The taller one. You can find some more of them little bitty old beads. Yep, there's one. Let's see, we got a big and a little, a big and a little, and a big one. Yeah. Do I have any more little ones? Don't look like it. All right. Well, we'll just do two big ones and a little one. Two big ones and a little one, and two big ones. How about that? All right. Put these away. Okay. Now, let's take this one off. Pull it out. Put your two big ones, then your little one. Two big ones. And pony beads. Remember, y'all, the pony beads are really colorful, so you can use those. There you go. And there we go. go. Let's see. Would that be too many? No, always take them off. All right. Yeah, let's do that. Let's take them off. Let's take a few of them off. It's not fun to have a bunch of them because you can't go round and round and round. Let's see. Maybe we'll just do this. Let's do a big one and a little one. A big one. You don't want too many because it's really not, you know, it's not that big. But you want to make it fun just to sit and play with. And a little one. Maybe one more big one. There we go. All right, let's do that. Let me see how this one works. Push it down in there. There we go. Whee! Here we go. Okay, I have a bead that don't want to go for some reason. Do I have a little bitty crooked neck? Maybe I need to stretch it out a little bit more. If you find that it won't go in or around, just kind of pull your wire a little bit. And let's give it a try again. Nope. It's got a little kink somewhere right there. All right. Just keep playing with it until you can get it to go where it needs to go, around and around. Let's see. One more little test drive. Beep. Better. That's better. Here we are. All right. Kind of straighten this up a little bit. It's a little bit crooked. Okay. There we go. Look at there. How about that? Okay. Ah, that is fun. Look at that, y'all. I can sit and play with this all day long. Wee-wee. I could probably take one more of these off since we really don't want anything right here. So we'll pull this one up again. And we'll put... Put a little on there. How about that? Okay. So, I'm going to pull this back off. Redo them again. No hurries. No hurries. Do the small. The large. Oop, there it goes. The small. The large. There it goes. And a small. Let's see how that works. Push your wire down there. Okay. That's it. That's better. Okay. Now, say bye-bye to the beads. We're done with those. Now. If you want to, you can paint these, which I think it looks fine. See there? There we go. How exciting is that? Isn't that just fun? Yeah, you can sit and play with it if you want. Any adult can do it. Sit it on your desk while you're thinking about your homework. Or just, you know, and share it. Share it with your brothers and your sisters. Which I don't think we need to glue it in. It's in there pretty good. So, there you go. We have made a wire beaded maze. There you are. I hope you had fun making your very own beaded wire maze. Yay, I am so proud of you. Well, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and make that like button happy and hit that ding ding bell so you will know when I'm going to be on again to make another craft for all you good little boys and girls out there. And yep, as always, we are going to have fun here on Mimi's Fun Time. So don't forget to be watching for my next video. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.